Consumer Press Force, and we're standing outside of Pub Rock Live in Scottsdale, Arizona, with the Canadian band We Were Sharks. This is Randy and Matt.
How you doing?
I'm doing well. So how are you guys faring? I heard you got some ink slung.
Yeah, a lot of the guys got some cactuses with Arizona, like AZ tattooed behind it. I mean, this is a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful place, honestly.
Oh my God, the weather. all the weather just coming in, and it's like 87 degrees and we're rocking shorts, whereas we have family and friends up in Canada and they're just
it's snowing.
Yeah,
they got a bunch of snow yesterday, and we get to be here in this beautiful, beautiful place. I mean, you may think we're like joking when we say we love it here, but we truly do. This is the first time we've been here.
Sweet.
And
yeah,
all of us have been like bitten by the Arizona bug.
Yeah. How much time have you had to spend here?
It's about 24 hours now, and I mean that's how fast it was.
Yeah, well, when the tour ends in a few days, come on back and hang out a little bit before you go home.
We will. we do that to like states we like. We're going to Nashville on the way back home. Just a quick little stop in Nashville. We a few of us are big country music fans,
sure.
So anytime we get a chance to like roll through Nashville, we're gonna take it.
Oh, yeah. Have you ever made it out to NAMM? You know, that's
me
in January.
I have not made it out to NAMM. I'd love to go one of these days, though, because it looks insane.
Oh, yeah. It's amazing.
I love seeing the recaps and everything on YouTube and everything like that. That's always how I spend my January. So what about you, Randy? You ever been to NAMM?
No. I'm in the ice-cold, frigid Canadian winters at that time, so.
Well, you got to drop into San Diego. Is it San Diego or L.A.? In January. And it's still pretty cool. Yeah. You know, it's a nice temp. So,
we're going to be in San Diego in a couple of days from now.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty excited. Pretty excited.
Yeah, so. It's nice. So tell me about the new signing. Is it Revival Records?
Revival.
All right.
Yeah, Revival Recordings. Yeah, so we just signed on to them about two months ago now. Very recent signing, but right off the get-go, they've been just an outpouring of passion and feels almost familiar, like they put so much into us, and even we met up with them in North Carolina, actually, on this tour, and meeting up with some of the executives and
Chapel Hill.
Yeah, Chapel Hill.
Also a great place.
Yeah, great spot, great food, that's for sure, and just really, really, like, close-knit family in that group, and we're so stoked to be on that part of the team, and we got big things coming up in 2020 with those guys early on. We're going to be in the studio and trying to knock out our next LP, hopefully.
Does it have a name?
No, not yet.
No, it's a secret, yeah. Right.
So Matt is the new guy, and Matt is very good with words, so you will see me holding the mic up to Matt quite a bit tonight. This is Matt's first interview with us, and I'm very happy that we get to do it with you.
Yeah, excellent. Well, you're candid, and, you know, we were teasing about
these good little dimples, right? Look at those freaking dimples. Look at those. Look at those dimples. I like this. I'm enjoying this a lot. This is fun. This is Matt's initiation now to the band. I love it.
All right. So what else is really fun for interviews? I mean, what's the wildest experience? Have you had an opportunity for Wild on tour yet?
For Wild? I think the wildest we've got is picking up White Claws here in America, because we don't get these in Canada. And a shout out to White Claw. This has been exceptionally fun on this tour. Honestly, I think the wildest thing has just been how overly positive this tour has been. Like, okay, so tour, you know, it's a great experience. Everybody, usually it's a grind, but like with the Assuming We Survive guys, we've never loved, we were with them for a short while. Those guys are like family to us now. And it's been exceptional. Every night is a ride with those guys. We jam out on stage with them, you know, we collab on songs and stuff like that. It's so much fun.
We were writing a secret album with them as well on this tour.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see you on stage together tonight and then checking this out in the
future. Damn it. That was a good answer to that question. Matt is from now doing all the interviews.
It's true, though. It's true. This tour has just been a wild ride of just fun and laughs, and yeah, wouldn't trade it for the world.
So next year coming up, you're doing the new LP tours. Are you coming back down here?
Honestly, right now, nothing's really truly booked for next year. We have clutter brains, and we get like all like messed up with everything. So right now it's just after this tour is done, it is all album. We're working with Paul Mark Russo again from Silverstein, who did Lost Touch.
Nice, yeah.
So we were all very excited to have him back working with us. But honestly, other than that, right now it's just the album. Just try to put everything we have into that album, and then I'm sure tours are being talked about and being booked, but that really, that's not our job, right?
Yeah.
Like, so we will, I mean, we want to come back down south, especially if it's like a winter tour.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Ideal. 100%. Now it's perfect. Right about Halloween is when the switch flips and it's
maybe
not really
summertime.
Cold,
I heard
cool.
Y'all get real hot around here. I said y'all.
Yeah,
you guys get really hot. You guys get really hot around here in the summertime. We might like skip that if possible, because I will melt. I will honestly melt. But I pick up Southern twang every time we're in South Carolina, North Carolina. It's all been like Southern states the last little while, so I will pick it up because I love it so much.
It's
honestly
a Tennessee influence, and then you'll have me talking that way very soon.
Absolutely.
So, what are you bringing to the writing process, being new with the group?
I'm new with the group, but I've known the guys for a little over 2 years now.
Oh, yeah.
Colin, the other guitarist, I've known him since I've been in college, and he knows I'm just a writing workhorse. That's what I do day in and day out.
Nice.
So that's honestly was one of the main reasons for joining the band.
We snagged him.
Yeah.
Getting to do the live stuff at this point is really just a big bonus. The big part that I wanted to do was help out on the next record and put my best foot forward for that. So
trying to write as much as
Matt, were you not on a little bit of Lost Touch?
Technically was on Lost Touch. I did record a couple of guitar parts for Lost Touch. So.
Matt may play bass, yeah, but he's one of the best guitar players I've ever got to witness. Matt is a very modest person. Matt is the youngest, Matt is the cutest, and he's very modest. He is a true Canadian. But having Matt with us, when we first found out he was going to join the band, our big thing was like, well, which one of you guys playing guitar is switching to bass, because he's really good, and that's nothing against our guitar players, but Matt is a great guitar player. But he was like, no, I'm gonna do bass. So yeah, which was mind-blowing to me. I think it's just because he wants to drink a bunch of White Claws and he only got four strings. Yeah. So you know, but Matt's big thing, it's the last album everybody kind of had a hand in as well, so it'll be very interesting. We did a couple of demos just shopping for new labels after we left Victory. And Matt had a big heavy hand in those as well. So they may never get released. But we're excited to go in. I mean, it's going to war pretty much. That's every time we go into a new album, it's pretty much going into war, you know. Going at all, everybody that's been listening to other stuff is like cheating on us, so we're going into war to bring them back to us.
All right.
That is the plan.
Yeah.
Right? So adding Matt to the team is a big bonus for us.
Excellent. Well, you guys have been playing since 2011, or has it been earlier
2010,
than that?
2010. 2010, when We Were Sharks first started. There's only two of us left from that time period, myself and the drummer Will. And we have looked at old pictures, and man, we have aged rapidly.
Time, yeah.
We have and we've also gotten bellies as well. It just happens.
Blame the can.
I mean, no, this is still, there's like 100 calories. Mostly it's like the Paps and stuff like that. But we've been around for quite a while, and we've just been slugging it. And I think that is probably why we've been good friends with the guys from Assuming We Survive. They've been slugging it for about 12 years now.
Yeah.
And there's just like this big respect thing for each other. And we'll probably talk about how close we are with those guys. So.
Well, absolutely. For the newbies that are out there, they're just starting their bands. What wisdom can you share with them? And I mean, you've had the experience of transitioning from label to label, and you know, what do you have to say about that?
Myself, you better make sure you love what you're doing. Honestly, you better make sure that you really, truly, truly do love it. With Sharks, I've been doing it for, it's going to be 10 years with We Were Sharks. In my old band, I was doing it for another 7-8 years. You better look yourself in the mirror and say, this is what I really, truly want to do. Because if you don't, then it becomes very hard. But if you do, it is pretty easy to go about working at it and pushing yourself to do more. just don't let up. That's the best advice I have for anybody that's starting a band. Believe in yourself. Really, truly understand that you want to do this, and do not take no for an answer. Go hard. Just practice. Work really, really hard, and just do it. Just do it. Do what makes you happy, because at the end of the day, that's all pretty much we're doing. We've been together for 10 years, and I sleep in a van most of the time, and we're having a blast, and I wouldn't trade it for the world.
Matt. Yeah, I think the biggest thing is don't get into it for the fame. Get into it because of your love for the music. Don't expect a paycheck out of this. Definitely don't expect a paycheck out of this. Like Randy was saying, you got to really, really love the craft. You have to really, really dig deep. There's going to be some hard nights. There's going to be some very cold nights. And like he said, it just has to be the love in the music. You can't do it for image. I know labels will want you to put on image and stuff like that, and you can use that to your advantage. You can't fall into it. You have to be yourself through and through. That's the big thing about getting through this industry, is really being yourself and just going hard all the time.
Absolutely. Absolutely. This is why he's doing the interviews for now.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Excellent. No, like, you just do it because you really, truly want to do it.
Keep trucking.
Hell yeah.
Keep trucking.
Yeah. What else should we talk about? Anything else? What do you want to say to the fans out there?
Honestly, for the people who have known us from the start, thank you so much. For the people who have now kind of caught on to us, honestly, thank you guys so much. I've been doing this forever now. If it wasn't for you guys, I would probably be at home right now. But I'm out here in beautiful Arizona, hanging out, doing a very, very awesome interview. And it would not be done if it wasn't for you guys, honestly, truly.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you guys so much.
All right. Thank you, Randy and Matt. We were sharks. It's awesome. So glad to make your acquaintance. Can't wait to check you out live.
Thank you so much. Yeah. Thank you so much for having us, honestly.
Good night, everyone.